like Nicodemus who went to Jesus by night. Give them the courage to say, what must I do to be saved? In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Oh, Lord God, and let us take everything that we've gained in the spirit, in our minds, and in our knowledge, and go out and do what you've called us to do individually. Help us, Lord God, not to speak against or talk against what you've called anyone else to do, because our walks are individual. Our purpose is individual in the name of Jesus, and we must give an account. Hallelujah, God, we say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, hallelujah, we count it done. We say yay and amen on today in the name of Jesus. We count it done, hallelujah, for you said whatsoever we desire. When we pray, if we believe, we receive it, we will have it. So we say thank you, God. You're a prayer answering God. And we say thank you. We worship you. We thank you. We praise you. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. No, y'all just patty caking. Praise the Lord, everybody. Let everything that has breath. I still see some of y'all looking at me. Clap your hands. Open your mouth. And give him the glory. That's what we're here for. Look up and down your row and make sure you're on the right row. Just make sure everybody on your row is a praiser. Come on, look up and down. If you see somebody not praising, you might want to move. Because I believe that he's coming to visit the praiser today. I believe he's going to favor the worshiper today. So let everything that has breath praise the Lord. There's strength in praise. He'll make you forget about everything you're going through if you praise him. Come on, ask me how I know. Because he's done it for me. Just put that all up and down your row and say he did it for me. He's doing it for me. Hallelujah. Come on, chosen, I've missed y'all. Hallelujah. I need to hear one great big hallelujah. Ah, there y'all are. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory. Glory. Hallelujah, anyhow. Hallelujah, anyhow. Hallelujah, anyhow. Never let your burdens get you down. When life comes way, lift your head up high and say, hallelujah. Glory. Do me a favor. Just look at somebody next to you and tell them, neighbor, I really don't have time to testify about everything I've been through. Tell them to say, but I got a hallelujah that'll explain it all.
Hallelujah. 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 Now, Diamond is too early for this kind of church.
We have some people in the room and they ready for regular church. And it kind of reminded me of when we were in the pandemic and we didn't have anybody in the seats. And we had to praise God in front of a camera. Some of y'all watched us with rollers in your head. Some of y'all was cooking in the kitchen. Some of you were driving down the street. Some of you wasn't dressed up. But it seemed like y'all knew how to give him an undignified praise. And I'm deep. Yeah. And wait, Diamond. And I'm looking at some of y'all that said, if I can just get back in the presence of the Lord, I'm not gonna let nothing keep me from praising him. Where am I? I'm not gonna let nothing from keep me praising him folk yet. Open your mouth and scream in this room. I want you to put your hands together and let's worship together, because he's an awesome God. I said he's an awesome God. Slap 7 people, high five, and say he's awesome, 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 awesome. Come on. Come on. Ooh.
My God is awesome. He can move mountains. Keep me in the valley, hiding from the rain. My God is awesome, heals me when I'm broken, strength when I am weak, and forever he will reign. Said, my God is awesome, he can move mountains, keep me in the valley, hiding from the rain. Hey, my God is awesome, strength where I am weak, and I am weak, and say, my God is awesome. He is
awesome.
He is
awesome. My God is awesome.
Can I get a witness here?
Awesome.
He is
awesome.
He is
awesome.
My God is
awesome.
Now this song ain't gonna work until you clap your hands. Come on, everybody clap your hands. Yeah, come on, Brandon, I can't hear you over there. Clap your hands. Hey.
My God is awesome. He can move mountains.
Hey.
Keep me in the valley. Hide me from the rain.
Hey, my God is awesome.
When I am weak.
Come.
When I am weak.
Baby. Hey, my God is
awesome.
He is
awesome.
Said he is
awesome. My God is awesome.
Look at your friend and tell him he
awesome.
My God is
awesome.
My God is
awesome. My God is
come
awesome.
On, chosen. Clap your hands right there. Come on, I want you to clap your hands like the enemy is in between them. Come on. Hey. Let's take it up, Diamond. Hey, he is
awesome.
He is
awesome.
My God is
awesome. My God is awesome.
My God is
awesome.
Tell your neighbor. Friend.
Awesome. My God is
one
awesome.
More round. Clap your hands right here, right there. Come on, right there. That's it.
if you have a, you know you serve an awesome God. Open your mouth and shout right there. I said, shout, chosen. Hey, say he's
awesome.
He is
awesome.
He is
awesome. My God is awesome.
Can I get a witness right there?
Awesome.
He is
awesome.
He is
awesome. My God is awesome.
Oh, say provide.
Protection.
Has he had to protect anybody
protection.
Here?
Awesome.
Say protection.
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 He is awesome.
Say he's holy.
He's holy.
Is he holy?
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy. He's awesome.
Clap your hands right here. I want y'all to double clap your hands in here. Come on. Wait a minute. They sound good. Let me hear just the drums. Clap your hands right here. This side look crunker than this side. Ah, come on. We almost there.
Awesome.
One more time, awesome.
Awesome.
Tell your name.
Awesome.
Tell your friend.
Awesome.
He is
awesome.
Awesome.
Said the Lord is. Said the Lord is.
Say it with me.
Said the Lord is. Whatever you need him to be.
Said the Lord is.
Whatever you need him to be.
Said the Lord is.
Whatever you need him to be. Whatever you want him to be. I know he is. I know he is.
Everybody, come on, say it in unison. Say the Lord. Everybody, hold the music. Say
the Lord.
Oh, put him in a
mind.
Whatever you need him to be, y'all. Whatever you need him to be on.
Said the Lord is.
Whatever you need him to be,
the Lord is.
Said this. Whatever you need him to be, y'all.
Said the Lord.
Everybody, come on. Whatever you need him to be, y'all.
Said the Lord.
Hey. Whatever you need him to be, y'all.
Said the Lord.
Whatever you want him to be, y'all.
Said the Lord.
Ha. Whatever you need, clap your hands right there. Come on. Chosen, where you at? Come on. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Said the Lord.
Said the Lord.
Whatever you need, whatever you want.
Said the Lord.
Hey. Whatever you need, whatever you want.
Said the Lord.
He'll be a bridge over troubled water.
Said the Lord.
Hey. I tried him for myself and I know. Said
the Lord.
Hey, anybody know he is? My God is awesome. He can move mountains. Keep me in the night. Hide me from the rain. My God is awesome.
Strength when I'm broken. Strength where I am weak. Forever he will reign.
I think we want to keep this train moving. If y'all want to keep this train moving, somebody scream right here. Oh, that was a slow song. Scream if you want to hear another upbeat song. Oh, that was in the medium. Just open your mouth if you love the Lord.
Chosen, here it is. Come on. Lord, I love you.
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 Lord, I love
more than anything.
More than anything.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
I place no one above you. Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love
more than anything.
More than anything.
I love you, Lord.
I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord.
I love you.
I love you, Lord.
More than anything. I love you, Lord. Let's go. More than anything. Clap your hands right here, chosen. Clap your hands right here. Come on. Clap your hands right here. Come on. Clap your hands right here. More than anything. Clap your hands right here. Clap your hands right here. Clap your hands right here. Hey, come on. Say, say, I love you. More than any,
more than any.
I need it. More than any.
Whoa.
Whoa. Come on, chosen. Set.
Whoa.
Sound the alarm.
Whoa.
Right, come on, that's up.
say, I love you.
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 More than you
need. Come on and give him praise. Come on and give him praise. Woo. Look at somebody and tell them, I don't know how much you love him. Tell them, say, but I love him more than anything. I love you, Jesus. Worship and adore you. Just want to tell you, I'm gonna leave this alone. Lord, I love you more than anything. Lift your head, sing it one time. I love Jesus. Come on, chosen. I worship and adore you. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything. We're on assignment. We're going to move this train along. At this time, I want everybody to stand up on your feet if you're sitting. And I want to welcome to the stage the Chosen Youth Dance Team. Come on, make up some noise for Chosen Youth.
Yeah. Would you put your hands together for our Chosen Youth Dance Team? Come on, you can do better than that. Put your hands together for our Chosen Youth Dance Team. Why don't you look at somebody to your left and right and say, I don't know about you, but my testimony is he turned it. Would you just turn in a circle? Maybe that ain't your testimony yet. Maybe you're looking for him to turn it. But just be prophetic with your body language and just turn. Something around for. Hallelujah. We got to keep it moving. It's not a youth Sunday. It's just a normal Sunday in here, but I feel like we upstairs. Do me just one more favor, and I'm going to move this thing along. But I just need everybody that's alive, and you know that he turned anything around for you. Do it one good time. Jump up and turn around and say, he turned it. Chosen vessel where your miracle awaits. No, I gotta come out of that for real. No, I really do. I really gotta come out of that where your miracle awaits. I'm sorry, I gotta do 60 seconds. Get it out your system. Hurry up. come out of that. Look at somebody, pull them down. Tell them we'll be back. We'll be back. We'll be back. We will. But praise is comely for the upright. Some of y'all came in here heavy, but I put on the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. One good time, get me out of here for real. Welcome to Chosen Vessel, where your miracle waits. If you are a first-time visitor, can you stand to your feet? First time. Come on, clap your hands. Come on, clap better, first-time visitors. Now, you all that are standing up, if you can pull your phones out real quick and text this word on the screen. It's coming in about a minute. It's coming. Hey, what's up? I see you upstairs. He waving. He like, we ain't in you church. Real quick, what's your name, sir? Daryl, good to be. I'm so glad you're here with us today. Y'all clap your hands for Daryl. What's your name? Tahira. Good morning, Tahira. So thankful that you're with us today. He sat down. What's your name? One more time. The Jollies. Come on, y'all got joy. Thank y'all for being with us today. What is your name? Sorry. Miss Sharp. So good to see you today. What's your name? Is your family with you? Oops, excuse me. What's your name? Sister LaShonda, what's your name? Raylan. Anaya, so thankful that y'all have joined us today. Man of God, what's your name? Tracy? What up, Tracy? This your wife? What's her name? You don't want to stand up? You don't want us to see you? It's okay. I get it. So thankful that y'all are with us today. Man of God, what's your name? Brother Lynn. I like it. So thankful that you're with us. Woman of God, what's your name? Gloria? Y'all, thank you so much for being with us. In the balcony, what up? What's your name? Tiffany? Thank you for being with us, Sister Tiffany. What's yours? Denise? Dowie? So thankful that y'all are with us today. Can y'all clap your hands for those on this side? We moving. Woman of God, what's your name? Uh-oh, yes, ma'am. Sister Carol? Carolyn, I'm sorry. Sister Carolyn, thank you so much for being with us. What's your name? Minister Sonia. Come on, thank you for being with us today. Sister right there in the red, what's your name? Sister Robin, thank you for being with us. What's your name? Venice? Sanaya, thank y'all for being with us. We got woman of God. What's your name? Sister Terry? Thank you for being with us in the upper room. Thank you. What's your name? Sister Savannah, thank you for being with us. What's your name? Angela, thank you so much. Man of God. How dare I? What's your name? You in the yellow. He had to look down. What I got on today? Yes, sir. Scream it. Lee? What up, Lee? What's your name, young man? He said, I'm just going to stare and smile. Welcome you two. Come to Chosen Youth next week. What's your name? Chris? Jason? Grayson? One more time. You screaming. Grayson! Thank you so much, Grayson. What's your name? Pastor? Okay, I'm sorry. Dr. Kevin, thank you for being with us. What's your name, sir? Tiger Martin, thank you so much. Man of God, what's your name? Richard Russell, thank you so much for being with us. Anybody else in the balcony? What's your name? Elnet, thank you so much for being with us. What's your name? Sabrina. Sister Sabrina, thank you so much. What is your name, woman of God?
Karen.
Thank you so much, Sister Karen. What's your name? Sister Darlene? Darlene. Just say it quick. Got you. Sister Darlene, thank you so much. Man of God. Norris? Brother Norris. Norris. Ooh, Brother Norris, thank you so much for being with us. Sis, what's your name? Sister Laura, thank you so much. On behalf of our pastor in our church, can y'all clap your hands for all of our visitors? Clap louder. Come on, clap louder. Thank you so much. Hopefully you all have already texted this number. We want to make sure that we stay connected with you. Please turn your attention to our video announcements.
Hey, Chisholm Vessel, it's Courtney.
And it's your boy, Matt.
Are you ready for this week's announcements? Well, say it with me.
Let's go!
As a ministry, we are on a mission to impact our community, to change lives, as well as to build the kingdom of God. And we believe that we cannot do it alone, beloved. That we need your help, we need your support, as well as we need your partnership. In 1 Chronicles chapter number 29, verses 3 through verse number 9, we read about the generosity of the children of Israel when they were building the temple. They gave, beloved, everything that they had to honor God and to build him an extraordinary house. And we believe that we can follow their example and we can do the same thing. We have set a goal this year of raising $250,000. And we're asking everyone to partner with us in this mission. As of 2022 in October, we began to talk about this and we challenged each and every individual to sow at different tiers. We challenged 250 of you all to plant a seed of $1,000, another 250 to plant a seed of $500, another 250 to plant a seed of $250. And the reason why we did this is because we want you all to know that every seed counts and that every partner matters. Together, I believe, beloved brothers and sisters, that we can reach our goal, that we can continue to advance the kingdom of God. Now, I understand, beloved, that giving can be difficult, especially in these uncertain times. But we also know that when we give sacrificially, when we honor God with our finances, he blesses us in return. In Proverbs chapter number 11, verse number 25, it says, "A generous person will prosper, and whoever refreshes others will be refreshed." So I'm calling on everyone to partner with us in this journey. Whether you've been with us from the beginning or you are new to our ministry, we need your help. We need your prayers. But in this season, we not only need your help, your prayers and support, but we also need your financial contribution. We believe that we can come together on this first Sunday in the month of May. And as we give sacrificially and as we trust God, he will pour blessings out upon us and upon our ministry. And we know that together we can make a difference in our community and we can make a difference in our world. Thank you, thank you, thank you in advance for your partnership with us in this mission and this mandate that God has placed on our lives. May God bless you and your family abundantly as you give generously to the kingdom of God. May God bless you. May God keep you. This is my prayer.
Grace and peace, Chosen Vessel family. Felicia here with the Acts Ministry, acclimating Christians to serve. Guess what? Today is the last day to register. Go to our website at thechosenvessel.org. Register for the new members class that's taking place this coming Saturday. You don't want to miss it. And guess what? We're serving a continental breakfast and lunch provided by our own very own culinary ministry here at The Chosen Vessel. So please go to the website and register. We hope to see you soon.
The International Missionary and Christian Women's Auxiliary of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World Incorporated formally invites you to their May retreat and spring planning meeting. This is in Allen, Texas, and the registration fee is $175. For more information, make sure you go to imcwa.pawinc.org.
There's a refreshing coming. Bishop Marvin Sapp and Chosen Vessel Church invite you to the Refresher Conference. May 18th through 21st. Experience Pastor Kimberly Jones.
You have been having all of these things in your life, projects, to keep you from fixing your project. Because the enemy knew that if you ever got this in alignment, you were going to be a voice and the whole world was going to be going, where did she come from?
Evangelist Latrice Ryan.
God ain't barren, God ain't broke. Will not run out.
On Sunday, May 21st, it's Dr. Wanda Fraser Parker.
God is still with you, and you are still here. I need you to holler back at your girl and shout, I survived.
It's the Refresher Conference. And Saturday, May 20th, a multitude of events designed especially to refresh her. May 18th through the 21st, live at the Chosen Vessel, 4650 Campus Drive in Fort Worth. All the info is online at thechosenvessel.org. That's the Chosen Vessel.org.
What's up, ladies? This is your personal invitation to make sure you come out to our Refresher Conference May 18th to 21st. We have some amazing speakers on Thursday and Friday. Along with our regular Sunday service, we're open to the public, but make sure you make your way to thechosenvessel.org and register so you can enjoy all of what we have planned for you on Saturday.
For your registration, we have an amazing brunch plan. 3 power-packed and fun sessions geared for all ages. And you know we're going to get you right with the t-shirt apparel. Come ready for the day of refreshing your mind, body, and soul. And ladies, we wouldn't be refreshing if we didn't do some shopping. Come prepared to shop and support our vendors. From purses, accessories, books, apparel, you name it! You're going to want to come prepared. We'll even have the opportunity for a little extra pampering, like chair massages for a small fee if you're interested. Look, go to the website and get all the information you need. Come ready, all women of the Chosen Vessel. We need to see you there.
Momentum. Brothers, this is the jumpstart you've needed for the movement you've always wanted. Momentum Conference. Live at the Chosen Vessel Church, June 1st through 4th, with speakers like Bishop Anthony Gilliard.
And many of you don't understand, but what you're going through right now is to give you identification with the devil. God said, I allowed it to happen so demons can know what's inside of you.
Bishop S.Y. Younger.
If Jesus is not welcome in this room, I'm not welcome in this room. If I can't say his name, don't call my name.
And Sunday the 4th, conference host Bishop Marvin L. Sapp.
Maybe God's waiting on you to have the capacity, because what I'm trying to bless you with is bigger than what you've been believing.
And Saturday, June 3rd, a multitude of events to provide the momentum he needs. The Momentum Conference, June 1st through 4th, live at the Chosen Vessel. All the info is online at thechosenvessel.org. That's thechosenvessel.org.
Before I let you go, make sure you get connected with our church online. Stop by our website at thechosenvessel.org.
Get social with the vessel by liking our social media pages on Facebook, Instagram, and don't forget to subscribe on YouTube. We want you to tag us in all of your photos and videos taken at Chosen Vessel services and events.
That's all we have for you today, but remember our motto here at the Chosen Vessel.
We are a family plus this community of believers, building our faith one scripture at a time. Have a great day, Chosen Vessel.
Govern yourself according to all the announcements. There's one announcement we want to make sure that was not in our video announcements, but we want to ensure that we speak of, and that is the services for Sister Sandra Galloway's son, Sir Kevin Renard Howard III, will be on May 11th, and the viewing is from 2 to 6 p.m. at Rev's Funeral Parlor. That's 3615 Vaughn Boulevard in Fort Worth, Texas. And then the funeral service will be on May 12th at 11 a.m. at the Metropolitan Church of Christ. And that's 3201 Martin Street. So if you have any questions, you didn't catch that,
You can call our church office, and we are praying for them. Amen. We're praying for this family and all other families that are dealing with loss during this time. Well, I got one question for you, and that is, do y'all know what time it is? No, I'll tell our visitors a little louder. I said, do you know what time it is? Y'all, it's seed time in the house, and there are five ways that you can give here at the Chosen Vessel. If you need a envelope, can you please lift your hands? Our brother servants and our deacons are in the aisle way. They are moving now. Keep your hands lifted. There are five ways that you can give here at the Chosen Vessel. You can give by way of Givelify, by going to the Chosen Vessel Cathedral. You can give by way of Cash App, by the dollar sign TCVC Ministries. Make sure you look for that dollar sign TCVC Ministries. There's a number of them out there. Make sure you got the right one. You can also give by way of PayPal. PayPal by going to paypal.me/TCVC4650. And you can give by way of text by texting the word give to the number 833-948-1987. And you, if you desire, you already put them up, but you can get by way of cash, credit card, or check and make that payable to TCVC Ministries. Do me a favor, everybody stand to your feet. We're moving. Everybody stand to your feet. Would you just repeat this out to me and say, this is the house that favor is building. Come on, say it a little louder. This is the house that favor is building. You know what we do here, Chosen Vessel. Let's show our visitors. We wave our seed. Come on, hold it up in your right hand. We give God what's right and never what's left. We wave our seed. Come on, say it with me. We wave our seed because we're waving away debt and waving an increase. The reason why we wave our seed is because we're getting the attention of the Master. We are telling God that we don't give grudgingly nor of necessity, but we're cheerful givers. Come on. We honor him with the fruit of our labor because he has honored us with the activities of our limbs. We honor him with the fruit of our labor because he has honored us with the ability to inhale and exhale. This is not a debt we owe, but a seed we sow. We seed into good ground, believing that God is going to give us back some 30, some 60, some 100, and even some 1,000-fold return for the seed that we're about to plant into the kingdom of God. Come on, most importantly, come on. We give our seed an assignment. There it is. Its assignment is to go into our future, to create avenues and streams of wealth and increase where we will not live off of that which we make, but we will live off of the overflow of that which we sow. I need you to holler out, I'm expecting a harvest. It's gonna rain in my life. And from this seed, I declare and I decree that I will never be broke another day in my life. Would you shout it loud and shout hallelujah? I need these two, please pass your seed in. These two rows, please pass your seed in. On this side, please pass your seeds in. Our music ministry is coming under the direction of Pastor Myron Williams. But listen, we are so thankful that we are always left in capable hands. The Bible declares that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. I got one question. Does anybody need a word from God? Then we're in the right house. He needs no introduction, but for some he may. But by the time he puts the mic down on this podium, you will never forget him. After the music ministry comes, I'm gonna ask, out of respect for the office, that we all stand to our feet and we give God praise for the manservant for this day, the Bishop George Awesome Dawson.
I've got so much to thank God for. so many wonderful blessings and so many open doors. Oh, I bring mercy along with each new day, and that's why I praise you. And for this I give you praise. For waking me up this morning, for starting me on my way, for letting me see the dawn of a brand new day. Oh, a brand new mercy that's come along with it. New day,
yeah.
I praise you for this. Because you've given me brand new mercies each day. That's why
I praise you.
For this I
give you praise.
Just want all the chosen to stand up on your feet as we prepare for this word and lift your hands and say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For this.
For this. I give you praise.
Come on, chosen. Lift your voice and say praise.
For every mountain.
Come on, you brought me. Chosen. Lord, you're my provider.
You brought me over.
For every trial. Come on, in that balcony, did he see you through?
For every blessing.
Hallelujah.
water. Come on, open your mouth. Give God glory. Look at somebody and tell them, for every mountain, he bought you over. Tell them, for every storm that you had to face, for every witch that tried to curse you, for this, look down your row. Tell everybody on your row, to this, come on, give him all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor. To the incomparable, the greatest worshiper in the land, my blood brother, that's the Myron Williams. None like you nowhere. And that's one of my favorite songs, man. And we thank God for the worship ministry, the heart and soul of what Bishop Marvin Sapp do. Why don't we clap our hands for the one and only, my brother, Bishop Marvin Sapp, my friend. This is one of the greatest pulpits in the world. And I don't take it lightly when I get a call from Shalanthia to say, Pastor Sapp needs you. And I'm honored to be here this morning. Whether y'all know it or not, some of y'all don't know, this is home for me. I cut my teeth with the one and only Bishop Richard Young. And Lady Young, I practiced on some of y'all for years until I learned how to preach. But I'm glad to be home in this pulpit. One of the greatest preachers and singers of our time, Pastor Marvin Sapp. And to the whole household of faith, to the leadership of the Keith, and to the leadership, to all of you, and our youth leader, I had the privilege. All y'all owe me real big for him. Because he got in one of the vehicles of my prophetic gift. I prophesied him from Kansas. I was in a revival one night, and I told him, God said, leave Kansas and get to Texas. One of T.D. Jakes' armor bearers was here, and I told him the same thing in Columbus, Brother Rashawn. He's sauce boss, top chef in town now for the Dallas Cowboys and all that. Gave him and Eric the same prophecy. Eric owed me for his wife. I prophesied his wife. While he was doing the wedding, I said, I hear a baby crying. He owed me for his kid. I'm going to collect before I leave. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And the awesome team showed up with me today. These brothers right here on the second row, and the one on the front row, Brother Tiger Martin, the number one soup man in the world for Minnesota, flew in from Minnesota to hang out with us today. And he's the tailor for the Minnesota Vikings and the basketball team there, and he made me wear one of his suits. I'm trying to look like the youth. I came in here today with a t-shirt on and some blue jeans and some some sneakers, I'd have been right on point. But I'm clean today. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I ain't clean enough to prophesy, though. I'm about to prophesy in this place. Now, Sam is the teacher preacher. I can't out preach him, but I can show no prophecy. Now, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to release one scripture. If you don't praise him off this scripture, you ain't got the Holy Ghost. I'm going to release this prophecy in this room, and it fits everybody. And then I'm going to get into the message. And my message is one word this morning, and that message is manifest. I want you to do something crazy. I want you to grab everybody on your row, shake them and rock them real good, and tell them everything you've been praying for is getting ready to manifest. Turn around, get somebody else, and tell them I've been praying for something, and I'm waiting on it to manifest. It's about to happen. I said it's getting ready to happen. Lord, I thank you. You came on the right Sunday today. I want you to find five people and tell them, get ready for a manifestation. Sunday, you gonna have a miracle in your hand. Yes, sir. Sit down, y'all. Let me give y'all this one scripture. Myron, I want you to help me preach just on one scripture. And it's floating in this atmosphere. I'm just going to grab it. It's Psalms 115, verse number 14. Find that on it. Somebody give that to my. No, I don't want them to put it on the screen. Don't put it on the screen. I just want it to jump off the page. I want to go old school. What I want them to put on the screen is what I'm going to preach on is Mark chapter 10, verse 46. Y'all can put that on the screen. But this scripture is not the message for today. This is just what I heard as a prophet when I was sitting down. I heard this, and God said, give them the antidote to the manifestation. Give them a prescription. What I'm about to give you is a prescription for this week on something that God's about to do. somebody and tell them, I just need a prescription. I need a booster shot.
You want it?
What did it say, Byron?
Is it, you said 115.
Psalm 115, verse 14. What did it say?
Verse 14.
They already got it. They're ready to go.
Jehovah, increase you more and more.
Stop! He said, tell everybody who got the Holy Ghost and ready to shout right now, I'm getting ready to increase you. Grab your neighbor, shake him and rock him, and tell him, this morning is my morning of increase. Pastor Saf, I'll be done before 1 o'clock. but I feel a manifestation. It's in this room. This is no longer just an apostolic church. This has become a prophetic center. That what we speak in this place, it manifests overnight. And somebody lift your hand and shout, I got something coming. And I know it's coming based upon all the hell that I've been through. And if you ain't been through nothing, don't say nothing. Everybody who's gone through a recent attack, open your mouth and shout, I got more coming. He messed with the wrong one when he messed with you. Come on, Doc, give me Mark. Give me Mark chapter 10. Shandu. Somebody say amen. Give me Mark 10, 46. Anybody got it in the audience? Who got it? Come on, let's go old school. Read it out loud. They did what? They came to Jericho. As he went out of Jericho with his disciples and a great number of people, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway begging. I want you to tell somebody next to you, my begging days are over. Now tell her why it's about to manifest. Read. And when he heard it was Jesus of Nazareth, what did he say? Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. Tell somebody that's what I need. I need mercy. Come on, Doc. Read, sir. Many charged them that he should hold his peace. He got louder. Come on. Thou son of David, have mercy on me. Come on. Jesus stood still and commanded him to be called. Let me tell you what's happening in here right now. The first scripture that I released caused Jesus to walk in this room and stand still. You don't want to get Jesus' attention and do nothing with it. Look at somebody and ask them, what you going to do with this Jesus this morning? Come on, talk to them.
And they called the blind man.
They called the blind man.
Saying unto him.
What did they say to him?
Be of good comfort.
Be of good comfort.
Rise.
Rise.
He calleth thee.
He calleth thee. Come on.
And he casting away his garment.
Casting away his garment.
Rose and came to Jesus.
Came to Jesus. What happened?
And Jesus answered and said unto him.
What did he say to him?
Wilt thou that I should do unto thee?
Well, what you want me to do for you? This is what Jesus is asking us this morning. What y'all want me to do for you? Come on, talk to me, Doc.
And the blind man said unto him,
what did he say?
Lord, that I might receive my sight.
I don't want a house. I don't want a car. I don't want no more clothes. I don't even want no friend. Just give me my sight. Just let me see again. Tell somebody next to you, God's about to open your eyes today. Come on, talk to me.
And Jesus said unto him,
what did he say to him?
Go thy way.
He didn't lay hands on him. He didn't spit on him. He just simply told him, go your way.
Thy faith made thee whole.
Faith. faith is working on your behalf. My subject for this morning is manna. Let me open up by making this statement to you this morning. That movements are created by moments. If nothing is moving in your life, it is because you either have missed your moment. Every great story you read in this book of a prophet or a king, it had something, a moment that traumatized their life in such a way that a movement was created out of, whether it be good or bad. If you sat here and think, right now, every one of you would think in your mind, you would say, I had a moment that made me pivot. It caused things to turn. And if I wouldn't have went through that, I wouldn't have this. Who am I preaching to in here? If nothing is moving, it's because you missed your moment. Or you danced around the moment. You got to go through something to get something. You got to go through ugly before you can get to pretty. Second statement I want to make is this. It is the arithmetic of God. God operates in mathematics. Talk to me here, church. This is how God operates. He subtracts. Then he divides. Then he adds. Then he multiplies. Y'all ain't gonna help me up in here. Think for a minute about your life. For 3 years here recently, we went through what is called a subtraction. I remember in the beginning states of Marvin coming here, I pulled up cars all the way around the block. But then we went through COVID. God subtracted. And the subtraction is like a rubber band. What God does in subtraction, like a rubber band, the further back you pull it, the faster it'll bounce back. I'm about to say something. If you don't shout right here, you ain't got the Holy Ghost. But I want you to reach over and tell your neighbor, I've been pulled back so far to wait till you see my comeback. If somebody high five and tell them, we're going to bounce back. We're going to bounce back. I had a temporary setback. But wait till you see my comeback. There's about 130 people in this room that's got a comeback. And you're going to come back so quick till they ain't even going to know what happened to you. Can I give you a comeback scripture? David said it like this, weeping only endure for a night, but joy is going to bring me back in the morning. I want to prophesy to about 80 of you to tell you that when you get up tomorrow morning, look for a comeback. You got to lose something to understand how good it feels to gain something. All of us have lost somebody. Somebody's died in your family that's close to you. And there is no answer to some of this stuff. You ask God, why me? And God say, why not you? You were built for the moment. What I'm going to do with you next, I got to decrease you before I increase you. John said Jesus is coming I baptize you under water and unto repentance. But there's somebody coming after me that's mightier than me. I'm not even worthy to unlatch his shoelaces. Y'all ain't helping me up in here. But for him to come, I got to decrease so he can increase. Then after God decreases you, he divides you. He separates you from people and stuff that don't fit where you about to go. See, there's some people that's in your now that if you take a picture with them, they fit now. 5 years from now, you'll look at that picture and say, what in the world was I thinking? Y'all ain't gonna help me up in here. So what is God doing? Can I tell you this? And about 80 of you gonna praise him right here. What God's doing is rearranging the furniture in your life. Y'all ain't gonna help me preach. Can I quote a rearrangement scripture? Daniel 2:21 says it like this. He changes the time and the season. When it says he's changing your time, he's saying that whatever has been trying to kill you has run out of time. If it ain't killed you by now, it's too late. If COVID didn't kill you, tell somebody he's changing my time. And he's changing my season. What that mean, when Daniel wrote that, it meant that he's changing your spiritual address. You may have done all the haters what all the haters said you've done. You might be guilty. But in the spirit realm, God has changed your address. So now when the hate mail comes, it can't find you and it's returned to sender. And every curse that has come at you in this room, guess what? It's just been sent back to the enemy's camp. I need 30 folk to jump on your feet and shout, return to sender. Myron, you better get me out of here. I'm about to tear this place up. Shake somebody's hand like you're gonna shake it off and tell them the curse did not work. There's a witch in your camp, and that witch just got on its broom. Ding dong, the wicked witch is. Then that scripture says, I'm gonna remove kings and set up new king. God said, I'm moving people out of your life that don't fit you. Stop begging them to come back. Y'all ain't gonna help me up in here. Stop crying over who dropped you. As a matter of fact, let me give you a sermon to preach to you. Tell them this, if you drop me, I'm gonna land on my feet. Y'all ain't gonna help me preach. Look down your row, see if there's a praiser on your row. If there ain't no praiser on your row, get off of it. Because God said wherever there's a praiser, there's going to be a 24-hour miracle. I'm about to tear this place up. You better get me out of here. Then I'm going to set up new kings. I'm going to put people in your life that can pay for all your dreams to come true. Out of this service, there'll be 6 millionaires made out of here. And if you feel like you're one of them, you got 30 seconds to tear up your rope. I came to prophesy. Open your mouth and shout, he gonna bless me again. Somebody
Somebody find you a good praise partner. Get you a praise partner and shout with him for 30 seconds and tell him he gonna bless you again.
Get in the tent. I got 10 minutes. Keith, I got 10 minutes. Tell Marvin I came to tear his church up. Blind Bartimaeus represents the mall. He's been subtracted. He's blind. He's been divided. His father and his mother gave birth to him, a blind boy with a curse. And the curse is in his name. Blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus. Blind Bartimaeus. Bar means son of. Timaeus means a dirty man. He's the son of a dirty man. He blind because of five ingredients. Number one, he's blind because it's in the gene. And some demons that you are fighting are not your demon. It's a part of the genetics of your family curse. But today there is a praise in this place that's gonna kill a generational curse. And the Holy Ghost said, the first 100 people that go, put your foot on the enemy's neck and go to shout, I'll break a generational curse. Grab your neighbor and say, hey neighbor, what happened to my mama ain't gonna happen to me. What happened to my granddaddy ain't gonna happen to me. The devil is a liar. I'm breaking this. Number two, it's in the blood. It's in the bloodline. The DNA of blind Bartimaeus came from his daddy's bloodline. Some things you can't help because it's a part of the bloodline. Y'all ain't gonna help me up in here. But the whole reason that we come to Jesus is because of his blood. I'm not gonna argue with the homosexual. I don't argue with no homosexual. I argue with no transvestite. I don't argue with Donald Trump. And a bunch of MAGA Republicans. I ain't gonna argue with these folks. But if you're gonna come to the cross, you must be born. Y'all ain't gonna help me up in here. The argument ain't about how you came in the world. It's how you're gonna leave this world. And the truth is, any man come to Jesus must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder to them that diligently. No man get to the Father but by any man come any other way. He's a robber. Y'all ain't gonna help me up in here. And it's in the name of Jesus that every knee shall bow, every tongue, that's the apostolic in me, must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And there's only one way to get to him, that's through the blood. It reaches the highest mountain, flows through the lowest valley. Blood gives us strength for daily life. Number three, for him to get his miracle, 12:30, for him to get his miracle, pull me 12:40, man, for him to get his miracle, I got to go home at 4:00. My wife gonna be looking for me, or I'm gonna be blind by the man's. Y'all ain't talking to me. For him to get his miracle, he had to go to Jericho. Jericho, the worst city in town. Jericho is where the robbers and the thugs and the thieves. He's going to get his miracle in the hood. Y'all ain't going to talk to me. Sometimes you got to get low before you come up. You got to go down. Y'all ain't going to help me preach. And he goes to Jericho. The question is, what is Jesus doing in Jericho? Out of all the places the King of Kings could hang out, Jesus is in the hood. He's where ministry is really needed. Y'all ain't gonna help me in here. Jesus is in the hood, but he's there for a reason. He's looking for somebody that he can give a miracle to. And he's in the hood, blind Bartimaeus, positioned himself. If y'all don't hear nothing else I say today, y'all gotta hear this. The reason why you're going through what you're going through right now is because you're going through a repositioning. God got to put you where he can find you. And about 13 of y'all going to shout right here. He's got to make you uncomfortable to bless you. Rashawn Johnson, if you've been uncomfortable lately, it's only because he's setting you up for the blessing of your life. Blind Bartimaeus is uncomfortable. And the question is, why would a father take his son who has no blind and put him on the street and leave him to die? Now he's begging, trying to find. Blind. Begging. In my closing, I just want to see how it be that if I was blind, how would God get to me? Be blind. Here he is. Blind. Come here, Tiger. Here. Lead me to the edges. Yes. What you sanctified people don't know is that if you handicap me in one area of my life, it causes the other areas of my life to manifest. Shake your neighbor's hand and say, hey neighbor, don't get it twisted. Even though I can't see, I can still holler. You might block my vision, But as long as I can call him, he's still gonna come to me. And I just heard the Lord say, some of y'all are sitting on the edge. You don't know whether to quit or give up, but tell your neighbor, I'm on the edge. I feel like God is getting ready to do something. I can't see my miracle, but I know it's on the way. So I'm gonna open up my mouth and say, thou son of David, have mercy. Y'all got 30 seconds to ask God what you want. He's on the main line. Tell him what you need, and it will manifest. Open your mouth. Wait a minute. He blind. He can't see. He's on the edge. He's ready to quit. He has slid into a place in his life that don't make sense, but it make miracles. Grab your neighbor and shake him and rock him real good and tell him, I've been going through some stuff that don't make sense, but a miracle gonna come out of it. Come here, Tiger. Yeah. 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 Y'all ain't here. Where you at, Eric? Lead me to the middle. And what God's trying to do is lead you blindly, but he's gonna put you right in the middle of every miracle you asked him for. And if you praise him without eyes, if you shout and can't see it, in a few days, a manifestation is about to hit your house. Let me give you this last one, cause Keith gonna pull me. Keith, here's the last one, Keith. Come on with me, Keith, this is the last one. What y'all don't know about this story, that this was the last miracle that Jesus would perform before he went to Calvary. Out of all the miracles that he can give, gave it to a blind man who was cursed. And I come to tell somebody, I need 200 people that's looking for a miracle, that know that if God had one more miracle left in this place, are you the one to get it? How you gonna get it? You better go get it now. God said, tell everybody, get up, shout now. There's one miracle in the room waiting on you to shout. Everybody on your feet. Everybody get a good praise partner. Everybody grab somebody hand in hand. If you got family that's here, find your family, find your children, get your husband, grab him and hold him real tight and tell him, I got one miracle that I'm looking for, and I'm not gonna leave here until we get it. Now y'all open your mouth, and if they don't dance with you, if they don't shout with you, I'm gonna take your stuff back to Sugar Land, Texas. Pick up your feet. Go to shouting right now. Come on, band, we ready to dance. I gotta go. My time is up. Get you a dance partner. Kick your shoes off if you gotta. And go to dancing with them and tell them manifest. Right.
think the hand that you got is the one, but get you somebody else and tell them, God, go open your eyes this week and your miracle go manifest. Now dance with them until you see it come to pass. It's the last chance for everybody to get that one miracle that you've been waiting on God to give you, to get your prayer answered. Run to somebody else. Get in groups of twos, threes, fours, fives. Y'all do what you gotta do, but you gotta dance until you see it. You gotta shout till it manifests. Pick up your feet. Pick up your feet. Pick up your feet.
My time is up. Hands are lifted. I got 5 minutes to do this. Everybody that's waiting on a manifestation of some kind, you gotta make some type of sacrifice. Blind Bartimaeus sacrificed himself. He said, God, here I am. The disciples told him to hush. He got louder. In a minute, the ministry of this church is going to come and ask you to come. Be saved, be born again. In a minute, they're going to do that. But on the route of business, the blind man got his eyesight back. Went into the city. They saw him. He took his garments off and changed his clothes. When they saw him in the city, they asked him, ain't you that blind man? He said, yeah, I'm him. He said, what happened to you? He said, all I know is I was blind. But now I see. When they see you with your miracle this week, just look at them and tell them, all I know is that I was blind. Now I see. What I'm about to do right now is not for everybody, but it's for key people who's ready for a manifestation. I want 100 people in this room to sow a $100 gift
for the next 100 days, there'll be manifestation after manifestation. Every head bowed, every eye closed. I'll be the first to give it. I want 99 people all the way in the balcony to get that seed. Come meet me on this altar with it. And God said for 100 days, there'll be testimony after testimony. You'll run in this place. You'll hold your hand up and you'll be saying, Pastor Sapp, I got something to say. I was in the manifest service. Things broke. And I've never been the same. Get your phone, get your credit card. Run to this altar right now. Meet me here. If your house need a financial manifestation, God's going to open your eyes and show you where it's at. Those that need a new job, God's going to lead you right to the parking lot. Some of you been waiting on a phone call. These aisles should be full of people. Some of you been waiting on a phone call. That phone won't ring this week. Checks are in the mail. Money's about to be released. A career change is coming. Money for school has just been released. God said, I'm going to get into computers and I'm going to erase old school debt. There's 100 people in here that could sow this seed. This should be a $10,000 offering, very easy. Move now. Those of you that have 50 and you say, I don't have 100, but I got half. Move toward this altar. Move, move. Come on, I got to be out of here before 1 o'clock. Don't get me in trouble with Pastor Sapp. I want to come again. Come on. Listen to me. There are 10 businesses, 10 business owners in this room. The Holy Spirit says, sow $1,000 from your business. Watch your business blow up. 4 of you are one of the millionaires that I was talking about. You meant to sow 100, but God said, add more zeros. The only reason you ain't got your check yet because they add more zeros to it. Business owners, hear me. Get a major seed. Get something major. Sow it from your business. Come on. Eric, the enemy fought me all night last night. Attacked my body. Attacked my strength. But God, give me just enough strength,
yes, sir,
to get through here this morning. Myron, the Holy Spirit say, an outside source is going to increase your revenue stream. They're having a meeting about it right now. You'll know more about it before the year's up. You'll call me and say, Dawson, they increased me. There are 26 men in this room that are getting ready to receive increase overnight. It's going to blow your mind. Sean Johnson, I'll be seeing you this month. Prophesied to Evan Rescher, Ramp Church, about his wife. He put me on Facebook and they called me a lying prophet. Mary Reed got it. They posted it all over the world. Called me a lying prophet. I told him who his wife was. His wife was standing right in front of him on the camera. I said, that's your wife. Eric was there that night. Well, I went into a dark place for a minute.
Yeah.
The prophet, one of the greatest prophets in the world, Bernard Jordan, called him and said, take that down. Dawson is one of the most accurate prophets in the land. They took it down, and this month, I'll be at the wedding of Pastor Evan Rescher. Said all that to say because you're doing the feast. The Lord is getting ready to blow your mind, sir. There's a connection that's coming out of the east from New York City, then from Detroit. All over this country, your name shall pop up. God said you'll be flying in. You'll be doing football players all over the world. It's your time. Hands are lifted. Right there. When the Lord gets finished with you, everybody around you will have to bow down and say, it was God. This storm, it's been not a destructive storm, but like a hurricane. It's been spinning you. You've been like in a spinning top. Am I talking to you? But the Lord says, stand still in this season. You met a prophet this morning to tell you that all the winds that have been blowing, they finally have passed over you. Dry your eyes, pick up your heart, and dance again. God said, I'm going to start you fresh. There's a fresh wind blowing on your life. Somebody open your mouth. Those of you that can't do 50, you can do 25. You can do 20. Jump in line. Jump on this. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. My time is up. You got to be going out the door in 5 minutes. Come on, come on, come on. Jump on this. I'm getting ready for everybody that's got something that you want to sacrifice. Get your seed now. Stand to your feet with it. Make this sacrifice. Father, I release the miracle of open eyes. Let us see where the next blessing is coming from. Give provision. Let signs, wonders, and miracles follow us this week. Do one big favor for me as a prophet of God. Manifest. We ain't gonna keep praying about it. We ain't gonna keep begging. Our begging days are over. We just want you to do one thing. Manifest. For 100 days. While I'm driving in my car, I'm just gonna say, manifest. While I'm at work on my computer, I'm going to put it on my computer, manifest. I'm going to put it on my mirror. I'm going to put it on my screen. I'm going to put it all around me, all my bedposts, manifest. I need it to come to pass. Now get your seeds. Sow your seeds while you're standing in God's presence. Let God see you sow it. Business owners, plant that $1,000 seed. Plant that 100.
Yeah.
Come on, be honest in the spirit. After you plant it, hold your phone up. Hold your credit card up. And go to thanking God for your manifestation is coming. Pastor Keith, come on, take this mic. It's in your hands. Come on, Eric.
Amen. If you're sowing, hold your seeds up. Come on, everybody on your feet, hold your seeds up. If you're sowing. I just want you to just release this and just say, here I go, trust in God again. Come on, come sow your seeds, everybody. Sow your seeds, sow your seeds. Come on, sow your seeds. If you're sowing on your phone, just tap the altar and go back. Come on. Would you clap your hands for the Bishop George Awesome Dawson? Come on, chosen vessel. Can you give God praise better than that? Oh, wait, y'all can't hear. Come on. Can you give God praise better than that chosen vessel? Amen. As they're sowing their seeds, as you're sowing your seeds, we're in good time. I ask that we hold the doors, even as you're sowing. Come on, sow your seeds, sow your seeds, sow your seeds, and head back to your seats. Sow your seeds and head back to your seats. Here we go, trusting God again. That he's never failed us yet. Can somebody just give a hallelujah in the atmosphere? Come on, can you give a hallelujah in the atmosphere? Listen, listen, please, no more walking. Please, no more walking unless you're going back to your seat. Please, no more walking unless you're going back to your seat. Somebody has heard the word of God today. Somebody has heard the word of God today, and you're saying, I need to get my life right with Christ. That Jesus that you speak of and that's been talked about, I need to get my life right with Christ. As you're headed back to your seats, as we're even the holding the doors, unless you're in the balcony, please hold your seats. Everybody, close your eyes and bow your heads, please. Everybody, please, 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 please. Because if somebody under the sound of my voice, this is literally the most important part of the service. There's somebody who has made a decision. They're saying, I need to give my life right with Christ. There's some of you that's saying, you know what? When I get it right, then I'll figure it out. Listen, you didn't mess it up. You didn't break it. It was broken before the foundations. And guess what? Only way that you're going to get it right is by connecting with God. I need you while eyes are closed. Heads about. If you want to give your life to Christ, can I just see your hand? Can I just see you slip your hand up? Can I see you slip your hand up? Can I see you? I see those hands. Put those hands down. Listen, the Bible declares that if you are ashamed of him, if you're ashamed of me before, man, I'll be ashamed of you before your Father. You did not just say it because I asked you to do it, but it is the Holy Ghost that is pricking your heart. If you want to give your life to Christ today, I need you to do me a favor. Get all of your stuff and meet me at this altar right now. I need you to clap your hands because somebody's about to come. Clap louder like your soul matters. Come on. If you raised your hand, I want you to meet me down at the altar. Come on. Come on. If you raised your hand, there was some hands raised. I need you to come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. If it's you. Come on. If it's you. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Do me a favor, look to your left and your right and tell somebody, say, hey, neighbor, do you want me to walk down with you? Come on. And if they say yes, I need you to bring them down. Come on, bring them down. Meet us down here at the altar. Come on. Come on. Come on. There's not one. Hey. Let's move to this next plea, and we're moving, we're in good time. There's somebody that says, you know what, Pastor Eric, I'm in right relationship with God, but I need a church home. I need a church home. I want to make Chosen Vessel my church. If that's you, can you do me a favor? Can you meet me down here? I feel like somebody needs to join our family today. Is there one? If you clap, I promise you they'll come. Is there ain't one? Come on, if you clap, if you clap, I believe there's somebody that will come. Do me one more plea. Do me one more plea. Look to your left and or your right. Tell somebody, say, hey, you want to join our church? Tell them you ain't got to join next week. We got one. Come on. Come on. Clap. She's coming. We got one. If they say yes, I need you to bring them down here. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Y'all clap like you're excited that somebody's joining our family. Oh, that's so weak. Come on. Clap like you're excited that somebody is joining our family. You can go right this way. Come on. Clap as she's coming. Y'all stand to your feet. Let's go. Stand to your feet. Look down the road. Tell one more person. Say, you sure? Y'all sure? Y'all want to come? Y'all join? What? Oh, don't play. I mean, the car is coming. It's about, it's around the corner. It's manifested. It's coming down campus. I got you. All right, next Sunday's your Sunday. I feel it. Oh, we got another one. Come on, clap your hands louder. Yeah. Come on. We got time for this. Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Listen, everybody shout, next Sunday. It's Corporate Giving Sunday. Yeah. Come on. Next Sunday is Corporate Giving Sunday. It's First Sunday. We want to see you right here in the sanctuary. I know our bishop has something to say. Listen, look to your left and right and say, neighbor, I'm leaving here with this one word. God is going to manifest. He's going to manifest something. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling. God, I pray, God, that as we go home and we leave this place, God, that we never leave your presence. God, I pray that as we go home, that we don't get into any accidents with anyone and no one any accidents with us. God, when we return home, let us find our house in a better place than it was than when we left it. God, and we'll say it all week, manifest. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Have an absolutely amazing week.